Just saw something popped up when I read it. Said 19 minutes ago, so I guess breaking news and 90.5 FM KSJS San Jose. Yeah. That poor guy over there had a blog that lasted 29 days. And I thank him so much for going through this and going through the whole rigmarole about it. You know, back when I was in China in 2003, Tom Higgins, it was Tom Higgins that I emailed while I was over there once, and he said, you should do a blog. And I said, oh, what the fuck is a blog? People telling stories about their cats and you know, I didn't even know what a blog was at that time. Look at me. Do I look up to date? I look pretty tall, but my heels are high. So back in 2003, I said, fuck it, I'm not doing any damn blog. I'll just wait until technology catches up, and they haven't had a chance to put me down yet. And I'll just say everything I want to say. And when they shut me down from there, oh, finally, I can write a book. But it's funny to me. Here, this was supposed to be the biggest thing in the world, and you know, there are trailers for it. I got a trailer. Look at it. Go to my page, The Judas Resurrection. It's only 18 seconds, but it tells you everything about what's happening. You don't have to question anything. You don't have to go, oh, what if somebody doubts me? No, it's pretty obvious. It's all pretty obvious. There's no questioning going on. 29 days he made it. And then it amazes me too that, you know, all these people that he expects loyalty out of, the people that he keeps around him keep telling everybody what's going on. And I believe this. I do believe this. You're sitting in it. A demented home with some guy going, you know, yes sir, yes sir. He believes you, so he tells you everything. You don't believe a goddamn thing he says, but you share it. You're like, look at this fucker. You know, it's the only thing keeping us sane is all these people that, well, they say he shut it down and just eliminated everything, which I haven't seen yet. I'm not looking into it. Why would I want to have anything to do with somebody texting me all the time and sending me crazy letters? There was that one time when I was driving to work in Kalamazoo, and this message comes into my phone, says the President of the United States says, and I'm like, what the fuck? How did he get my number? You know, step into my personal business, my life. I'm driving and there's a text, and how can you avoid that? And you got the President of the United States trying to tell you something. And it's like, well, couldn't you have just said it in a State of the Union address or something? You know, oh no, I'll just get a blog and I'll invade your space. I'm not checking on any of this shit, even out of curiosity or dark humor. I'm not looking at it. Sitting on the other side of a tree, and that's where I don't want to be. That's what I see these people doing. They're like a squirrel. Once when I was about 12 years old, I saw a squirrel on a tree And I said, oh, squirrel. And I come around, and he goes, turns around, gets on the other side of the tree. He can't see me. And I kept walking around that tree, And he thinks as long as he can't see me, I can't see him. So he keeps his eye behind the tree. But you can see his feet around it all the time. Those claws, those fucking Krampus claws, long fingernails, fucking dirty dark hair. Just, ah. I don't want to get on that side of the tree where I think I'm okay because I can't see somebody. I don't want this guy texting me all the time. So he's quit it. He's embarrassed. He's quit it. He's gotten out the public eye, and I'm starting to wonder whether there's a Rasmussen or some other advisor, like Merlin. You know, King Arthur had Merlin telling him shit to do. And Rasmussen, well, he was for the Russians. Maybe, you know, maybe he's got Rasmussen telling him what to do. He finally said, you need to shut the fuck up. This isn't working for you. Like, you got 404 views. There's no telling. There's no telling. I only get like 12 over a year on a video, so it's not saying he's lesser or better. Just sometimes people don't want to hear what you have to say. This is a perfect time. The veil is lifted. Take a look. Just take a look. They're going to bring it right down. They can say anything they want and tweak your mind again. But just take a look while the veil is lifted. Look at both sides of this, and they're just maniacs. Who in their right mind would want to have a coup in America that supported either one of the races that are running things? You're obviously being fucking infiltrated in the head. There's something wrong with you. That's not to say come up with something better, because it's not easy to do. I can't just say go out and do something better. I'm gonna find you in jail blaming me. I'm like, I tried to tell you, I can't think of anything better. I can't think of any better way for it to work. But they can. They can just spout it all out. As it turns out, that poor guy is not going to be in so much trouble after all come August, because he's going to be reinstated. And I think August, he's going to be reinstated. He's going to be able to pardon himself, and there will never be an election again, and everything's going to be just fine. Wouldn't it be great to not have a moment to think for yourself, where all the time you're driving to work, you're saying, got to get to the job, got to get to the job, got to get to the job. Go and punch in, fucking run around like a maniac for 8 to 10 hours, punch out, run the hell out of there, and drive home thinking about the job, thinking about the job, thinking about the job. Wouldn't it be great to not have any individual thoughts at all? Gosh, you'd be so good at your job. And you know what? I see the ants over here. When one of those fuckers dies, they pick it up, they drag it back to the hole. What are they doing down there? burying it, having a fucking religious ceremony. No, they're just fucking eating it. So you just keep going to your job and thinking about nothing about it. Except when necessary, because a job is the thing that keeps us out of the woods. But you just keep doing that, and one day you'll collapse on the floor. Most likely it's 2 weeks after you retire. That's the common thing I've seen in person. I'm retired, there's a big fucking party. You know, you might as well stick a needle in the back of the guy's neck and kill him right there when he's eating his cake. Blow out the candles, make a wish. But evidently, August comes reinstatement. I say, wow. And I keep thinking, what's August? What's August? What is the meaning behind August? Because we've got Walpurgis night. Norm used to say they should give all of August to the veterans because there weren't any holidays in August, he said, Norm Spence. And turns out, and he's like, there's nothing that celebrates the veterans, but there is one in May there somewhere. I turned the page already. They do. It's just that nobody cares. And that's fine. That's what I'm promoting. Because people that will fight and die for you will never be cared enough about by you, unless you're a family member. You just use their name after that. Yeah, all those who died. Maybe write it down on the wall so they don't have to read it. August, as it turns out, when I say, why August is he going to be reinstated after all this time? I mean, it's been May, it's been somewhere in January, it's been, they keep changing the names, like, you know, as I've said before, like, the end of times, people that say Armageddon's here and it's, oh, let's all kill ourselves tonight. They all kill themselves and we wake up in the morning and go, you stupid bastard. Just keep changing the date. Not save the date. Change the date. So now it's August. And I think about August. I was born in November. November is like a Latin derivative or something. I don't know what you call it. It means ninth month. They threw a couple more months in there, the Romans did, because they were so arrogant. They just said, well, fuck it. We'll just say that it's because time isn't right and we have to get the calendar right. But we'll name one of me Julius, July, and one of me Augustus. All these Caesars. And so they just threw this shit out there and people believed it. And it seems that's what's happened to me now. That's the only logical progression I can come up with. Just making something up to keep everybody confused, you know? Hope is a little sister of worry, and all he's cramming down people's throats is hope. And she's got a cock the size of a fucking elephant. Not an elephant's cock, the size of an elephant. Just keep taking it. Why would we want to move on? I remember how peaceful traffic was after the elections, and people say, well, I guess, you know, the reasonable people were like, I guess. And then all of a sudden we had a coup. a bunch of people fighting for people that don't care about them. That's the one thing that I find interesting. And I finally heard it said, after months and months, how the bipartisan support of this money that they were giving everybody, never saw a dime. Army must have kept that. They said it was $1 million wound. They knew that to take the money away from their constituents would turn their constituents against them. Everybody wanted that fucking money. So they said, okay, that works. But other than that, straight back to abortion and Ronald Reagan and racism. Those things are all linked. You have to accept that it's all a ruse.